perfect timing for you
Who gives this beautiful, gorgeous bride away?
Her mother and I.
And what is your name, sir?
Jerry and Joella.
Is it your desire that she be joined together in matrimony with this man, Cody?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Please.
Go and get your bride. Beloved, We are gathered here today to celebrate the union between this man, Cody, and this woman, Callie, in matrimony. This is the highest commitment. Yes. Do you want me to sit? This is the highest commitment that two human beings can possibly make to each other. And it's not something that should ever be entered into lightly. If there is any person here who has any reason whatsoever to believe why these two people should not be joined together in matrimony, speak now or forever hold your peace. Very good. All right. To start off with the vows, Cody and Callie have decided to write their own special vows to each other.
You want to start?
Okay.
Usually, but that's okay.
I don't
All right. Callie, you are my best friend, and today I give myself to you. I love that you're always honest, you give me support when I need it most, and you give me unconditional love even when I'm a goof and mess up. I love your silliness and your beautiful smile, and I even love it when you're ornery to me. Today I promise my unconditional love and support to you. I promise that through the hardest times, I will be there to pick you up and make you smile, and together we will overcome. I promise that I will be loyal and honor you always. I promise to always be your best friend, lover, and equal partner. You are the love of my life, and I am so happy to be your husband. I look forward to spending the rest of my days with you wherever life takes us.
Very good. And now, Callie.
Cody, Don, I stand before you today in front of our friends and family. I'm ready to spend the rest of my life with you. I love how passionate you are about your work and how you've made that decision for you to help others. I promise to be there with you every day when life is hard and when it's easy. I promise to always listen to your opinion and value what you have to say. And keep your word to mind. Keep your best interests in mind. I promise to keep the love alive in our relationship. To keep my word to you and always be honest and faithful to you. And always speak when words are needed and to share the silence when they are not. To be your ally and never your enemy. To always love you and never take you for granted. I promise to stand by these vows and be an amazing wife to you forever. You have loved me every day and accepted me for who I am. And because of that, I am grateful to have you in my life and to have you as my best friend. I look forward to what life brings us. And you are my partner, my equal, and my love every day in every way. I love you.
Very good. Now, Cody and Callie, with the rings form the shape of a circle. And apart from being a whole lot easier to wear on your finger, they form the unbroken circle of love that two human beings, especially in a marriage, shall have for each other. You have the rings? Yep, good job, all right. And for Cody, if you would kindly place the ring onto Callie's left index finger. Embrace in hands and repeat after me.
With this ring,
I be wed.
I, Cody.
Take thee, Callie.
To be my lawfully wedded wife. I promise to always love you.
To always honor you.
To always respect you.
To always listen to you.
To always be patient with you.
And to always be your best friend.
And lawfully wedded husband.
Very good. And likewise, Callie. You would kindly take the ring, place it onto Cody's index finger, and repeat after me.
Take this ring, I be wed.
I, Callie.
Take thee, Cody.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
I promise to always love you.
To always honor you.
To always respect you.
To always listen to you.
To always listen to you.
To always be patient with you.
To always be patient with you.
And to always be your best friend.
And lawfully wedded wife.
Very good. Now, the couple has elected to partake in a sand ceremony. The significance of the sand ceremony is that when the couple came here today, they were two separate individuals, two separate human beings with indeed two separate lives. But today, when they leave here, they will be leaving here not as two separate individuals, but together as one couple. And thus, put the sand is representative of each of the two beings. And once it is blended together, just as when they are married, it is very difficult to separate. I know, I've tried. Tell you something very important. In a marriage, you can be one of two things. You can be right, or you can be married. But you cannot and will not be both. And if you don't believe me, ask my wife. 9 times out of 10, she's right, and we both know it. But she chooses to be married instead of always insisting upon being right. For the husbands, put your wives first. For the wives, put your husbands first. Let the small stuff go. And guess what? 99% of it, 99.9%, is all small stuff and ego. It's just not worth fighting over. There is also a very old and important and wise saying, happy wife, happy life. And she's shaking her head. Yes. Don't you forget it. I promise you. It is very, very true. You all will go through different life changes together. Perhaps a job change or job changes. Perhaps you'll move. Kids. Perhaps an illness in the family. A death. All kinds of good and beautiful and bad and very challenging things will happen as you go down this path together. But you have to be willing to cross that bridge, always sticking together. When the going gets tough, the tough do not get going. The tough have to sit back down, listen to each other, compromise, work it out. This is the best and difficult part. of any marriage. It takes work. Can you do this?
Yes.
Will you do it?
Yes.
Oh, good. Now, I checked both of my cell phones right before we started. There has been no phone call, no text message, no pardon from the governor. Are you absolutely sure that this is what you want to do? We had someone back out. Here we talked about that one time.
I did.
All right. Well then, by the power invested in me by the state of Oklahoma, it is my honor, my duty, and my privilege to officially renounce you, husband and wife. Sir, you can and should kiss this gorgeous bride. I present to you the happily married couple. Asked me to have all of you kindly pick up your chair and take it with you down to the reception room because they do not have it cleaned up for that.